All right then, so let's see what Mexico has to offer us. So when I last left off, I've just raided these ruins of like some like bandits and thieves and stuff like that. We managed to like, rescue a few of our like, shipwreck like companions over here in the swamp village. And basically sort of like just like, exploring the swamp area here. Let's see what we can find. First things first, let's get down here, we'll get this stuff. And I'm not sure there's much more to explore around here, so. Oh, there's a charge over there. I'll note, by the way, like, we're getting to like the edge of the map over here, so we'll have to basically go into like, the actual like, Mexico area over there basically to get anywhere else, so that'll be a thing soon. We're still in a marsh though, so that'll be fun. Note, by the way, with like the marsh, it's very hard to like get any patrolling going on here because basically no one's around. And hunting's also fairly difficult, but whatever. This first area is actually not that great for like, running around in it really at the, beginning of the game, but whatever. I'll do it anyways. And apparently I can't build any more lanterns because I'm basically out of whatever's over here, oil. So let's build some spike traps next. And we'll camp. Alright, so here's Tomas. You sit next to Laszlo Pawlik at the evening's meal. The Hungarian mercenary does not appear to be particularly enjoying his food. You don't like the food, Pawlik? He smiles and shrugs. I'm used to military food, but that doesn't mean I have to enjoy it. Your fantasy is very good. Are you still hoping to find Tamas here? Blah blah. Your fantasy is very good. Gracias, Captain. A mercenary tends to travel to many distant countries. It helps to have a talent for language. Are you still hoping to find Tamas here? A single stern nod. Like myself, he wore the black panoply of a Feket Sarag. He will not be difficult to identify if we find him or his remains. That is a dark thought. I harbor no illusions about the danger of his land. All evidence suggests that a bleak fate befell Gitaro's expedition. What will you do if you find him alive? I will not know until it happens. Perhaps he will be traveling with us? Will you leave our session after your request? Blah blah. Let's see if he'll travel with us. Laszlo stares into the bowl for a moment before replying. A strange tone creeps into his voice. His nature is difficult to pin down. Perhaps he will. And if we find him dead, will you leave? I am under your command. I will follow you until you no longer have me. Continue. You sit in silence for a while, and Laszlo finishes his meal. He excuses himself from the table and returns to his tent to maintain his equipment. He leaves you with a distinct impression that heavy thoughts are weighing on his mind, thoughts that he is clearly not prepared to share with you. So, that's basically Laszlo. Yeah, so we're starting to like go back over here, so we're going to get that right now. And you'll notice, like, I can't go like too deep into like the forested area over here because, like, now we're getting like out of the swamp, so that's a thing. There's a bit of a road. That's the road, basically, to get out of here. Ooh, and our pig over there. All right, let's see here. You need to get a couple of meat. More or less everyone in my expedition is looking really good with their morale, but I can always get a little bit higher on a couple of these guys if I can. Alright, we create ourselves in our spike trap. Ooh, look at that, we got ourselves a bunch of natives. So, Traveling through the swamps, your people struggle not to get stuck in the mud. You catch a glimpse of movement between the dead leafless trees ahead. Alright, so you can form up in advance, change your course to avoid trouble, blah blah. Let's just form up in advance. You pick a squad of followers and cautiously advance through the swamp. Soon you see a group of tribals between the trees ready to face your attack. So you got ourselves an attack here. Should be fun. Let's see Mercedes back this time around. We'll take some other guys. And let's take Teresa this time. To battle! Now, I should probably note, by the way, I don't actually remember a lot about these battles as I do, like, for the first campaign, because I only played this, like, you know, this scenario actually once. And by the looks of it, we just have a, you know, just a small group of tribals over here. It's nothing really major, so. Let's see here. Move you over here. You're gonna go right there. That's worked just fine. Yeah, we're out of range of these guys for a little bit here, so. Gotta get a little closer. There we go. Now I can get pot shots on these guys. Fire! Let's get you out here. Probably not gonna hit anything at this point, but you know, it's fine. Get you over here. And so they advance. Oh, that guy's gonna anticipate opening, I gotta watch out for that. So, who else likes the battle music of this game? Oh, they got another guy there, apparently. So two trappers, three warriors, a shaman. I'll send you here. We're just gonna tear this guy to pieces. Okay, these guys can move like six, I believe. So one, two, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can't exactly get up that guy just yet, but it would be nice to try. I'll send you over here. Send you up here. That's a miss, unfortunately, but oh well. You know, I don't really scare. I'm not really scared of that guy as these like trappers, because they could actually like, you know, cause me some issues. So let's just get you up here. Now let's just lock them down. You can go chase them as well. Unfortunately, my hunter's really close to this shaman, but you know, whatever. Oh, he's going back the other way. There's a stab. Whoa! I had her a little too close. So note to self, they can move a lot more than six. I thought they could only move six, but whatever. By the way, note that because, like, you know, Rain was down, he could, like, do his thing there, so that's a thing, but whatever. Down he goes. Can you go here, stun this one? Let's just get you up here. You're gonna come up here. There's a hit finally. Forgot about this soldier, so whoops, but whatever. Unfortunately, some of these tiles aren't, like, you know, fully colored, so there is some issues, but whatever. There's a miss, but whatever. Champ's gonna go the other way again. Ow. By the way, note that anticipate opening can only use, like, you know, you know, at like once, and after that's basically done. Whatever. Let's get you stunned. There's a stun on you. You can go over here and guard against this guy. Bang. Whoopsie, didn't mean to do that. Well, I'll make use of it anyways. Just go up here, blast him. Down you go. You can run over here. Well, I'm gonna take this guy right down right now, I guess. I don't think this guy's got another poison sting on hand, so we should be good at this point. He cursed me, apparently. Poison sting missed. Alright then, you're gonna charge him. One hit on him. God damn it, he keeps missing. Or she keeps missing, I guess. We'll stun him. Excuse me. Let's send this warrior over here. Or, you know, soldier. And you're just gonna sit there. You're gonna climb around him, I guess. Probably didn't need to do this, but down goes that one. Boink. Boink. Bloodthirsty again. I will say it's not ideal I lost, like, you know, Reyna, but, you know, whatever. Mistakes were made. Ow. Let's get you over here and do a couple shots. One miss. Two misses, because why not? Let's sit you over here. And we'll do a swing. And why not? What if you just shoot him? Finally, a shot with a melee weapon or missile weapon hit. So it lost Reyna, but whatever. Ooh, that was a really bad one too. Fatal bone fracture. You stand victorious. The troll is broken at your feet and writhing in pain from their injuries. Search your few enemies. You feel go over the dead and injured tribals and return for several valuable trinkets, a length of rope, and a little medicine for the shaman's pouch. So you can stabilize the survivors with 10 minutes if you want. I got, you know, extra, so why not? So open my basic light, just racist don't, but whatever. You order your people to administer basic treatment to your enemies, just enough to serve their survival. Then you're ready to be underway. Now, I will note, by the way, I'll have to basically, like, you know, help Reyna a lot there, but whatever. I made a mistake. I do actually make mistakes, by the way. Oh, there we go, we're trying to swamp slowly. Let's go toward the swamp village a little bit over here. Is there a cairn over there to go to, I guess, so we'll go that way. Alright, so we're gonna allocate meat. Reyna's gonna get healed up, so I'll obviously get to die, I guess. I suppose at this point, let's just make sure I get two meats to, like, everyone who needs, like, you. By the way, look at this guy. She's, like, devoted at this point. Yeah, some of these guys can get really, really high with their morale if you're lucky enough for it. Guess that's all I basically need to have for meat. She's the only one really low at this point, but whatever. Preserving. And I don't know why she's getting low because, like, you know, she's basically the racist in my group. Right here. This one right here. I'll show it off a little bit later, but basically she's the one who doesn't like when we're, like, you know, helping out natives, for example. You know what, Mercedes, how about you do that a little bit now? Just preserve a little bit. So, Reyna's condition improves a little bit. We found some rations from Aztec Soldier. I got tons of medicine, by the way, so I'm not going to run out of that anytime soon, but whatever. Get this. Now, I should probably note, by the way, I should actually be leveling up my guys. I'm gonna wait until I get 300 experience, I think, to level up the next person, but, I'll actually show off something very interesting, I think, next time. With, like, you know, the next guy I level up. Wow, this is a road here. Make good progress on roads, so that's nice. I don't think I'm missing anything over here, but you know, want to make sure for you know, let's make sure there's nothing over here. You still need to be retreated, so I'll assign you to me still. You're gonna hunt. Hunting's gonna be fairly hot, hard in a row, but whatever, that's fine. It's just how it is. A tribal attack. You are roused from your sleep by the sounds of battle. Tribal warriors have snuck through your apparently quite inadequate defenses and are running rampant through your camp. Men and women are running past burning tents, metal clashes against obsidian. Injured servants and troops scream for aid. So, you can basically do healing, see the wounded, or tactics, regroup center of camp, or just assume command of the fighting. This is actually a fairly hard one if I recall, so this is not going to be fun, but we'll see how it goes. We'll try tactics, because I do have good tactics. You grab a few of your people who aren't currently engaged in order to gather everyone in the center of camp. It takes a while before everyone is can disengage, but your troops are well trained, and for tactical oversight, they are soon guarded in a good tight formation in the center of a camp. Alright, let's assume command of the fighting. I'm not really good at healing, so we'll do this after. You find a vantage point and start barking out orders soon. The chaos is raining a little, and your troops are must get under command. Begin battle. So let's do this. Rita, Rosella, Syra. We'll have a doctor come in. Where's Gabriel? I guess Gabriel's like, you know, doing something else, so let's bring in Danielle in. And we'll bring in... I guess both my hunters are basically out of commission at the moment. That's not great, but whatever. We'll bring Mercedes in, I guess, to battle. But yeah, so if I recall correctly, this is actually a fairly difficult battle. There's guys here. And it might be like a lone guy over here, I think it was. Oh, this guy's over here as well. So we're basically in a pincer maneuver here. So it's not gonna be a fun battle, this one, but whatever. So Trapper, Man-Arms Trapper, Man-Arms Shaman, Trapper. So we got all basically the, like, you know, ranged guys over here. And these guys should be like warriors, I think, as well. So... Crap, where'd they go? I know I saw warriors over here somewhere. There they are. Yeah, there's warrior. So basically 8 guys, but they're basically like, you know, divided like a, you know, not very good formation for themselves, so we should be good on that front. Let's have the warriors go right here. And we'll see how this goes. I don't know if I want to get like out here as fast as possible, so just charge. You go there. You can go there. I'll get my scout to go over here. Now, all these guys basically are like, you know, veterans, so they can't do like the rain of arrows type of thing, but they're still gonna be annoying. Let's distract them for now. You can get out here. And a doctor can go to here. There's a stab from that shaman, but that's fine. That's gonna suck though. You know, I probably could have laid some traps for these guys, but whatever. Ouch. Doctor's taking some hits, which isn't great, but whatever. I'll probably be able to get on top of all four of these guys, so they won't be able to, like, you know, keep taking shots at her, but, you know. It's still annoying.
Yeah.
Ow. Bit of poison on her, but oh well. Okay, you get up here and we'll take a swipe. Nice critical hit. He's gonna get another stab on me, but that's fine, I think, so. Just stab once. Block that. And there, now we got these guys all locked down for the most part, because you can get up here. And let's see here. Just stab him. Stab that one. Down goes that one.
Yeah.
Two of my souls are poisoned, but that's fine. We'll deal with that in a moment. These guys won't be able to catch up in time, so, you know, we'll probably be able to take out the trappers and then, like, turn to fight them. Let's see here. More damage. And let's just get you over here. Nice critical hit. Take out this one. There goes that shaman. There we go. So these guys are all done with. Oh, one of the guys actually got close enough to get close to me, apparently. Didn't see that, but whatever. That's fine. Let's get you here. You here. Alright, let's start healing up people, I guess. So, heal up Syria. Ow. He's gonna take some hits there, but oh well.
Yeah.
Ow. Don't like that big 10 there, but oh well. That's just gonna happen. You can run around here to hit his guy. We're gonna do a distraction on these guys. Ow. But you know, have you done? Smack this one. Oh, block that one. Do a quick heal on her. Move here, we'll take you out. Maybe. Nope, not one of those, damn it. Another slash to him. I guess I'm taking a little bit of damage here at least, so it should be fine. Maybe. I'll say I'll team up on one person like that. Everything's on cooldown here for most parts, so down that one goes finally. Down that one goes. Ow. Quick heal on her. Play it safe as to stun this guy. They can't do anything. Stab him. Poison's finally gone off her, but you know. It's a little late for it, unfortunately. Yeah. That was that one. Stun this one. Not down yet, but almost. Finish him off. Mark Boneflash is on the Air Scout now, but oh well. The last attacker falls, and for a moment all is quiet. Then a cheer rings out from your troops. Sweat exhausted, stained with dirt and blood, you're nevertheless victorious. You and your people gather up the servants and set about the task of taking your wounded people to the medical tent and searching the bodies of your fallen enemies. On the shaman you find a bit of medicine, on the warriors and trappers a few pieces of useful equipment, and a surprising amount of rations. When you're satisfied that you've uncovered everything, your servants carry the bodies into the jungle to be disposed of. So, there we go, we had like basically like our first like, you know, we're under attack type of battle there. That happens, unfortunately, but oh well. Now, before I forget, I really need to go in here, and damn, I got a lot of, like, you know, issues now, apparently. She's fatal, she's severe, she's severe. Oh, this is not great. I do at least have better experience here, though. Now, I don't know if I want to. I can go in here and, like, you know, level these guys up, these doctors. I'm actually going to do this right now. The reason I'm going to level up these doctors, by the way, is that they actually have, like, you know, what can I say about them? Why do you have access to a pole arm? Whatever, I don't really care about that. Basically, like, you know, get these guys, like, you know, better, like, you know, skills when I basically do this. They get basically powerful, basically a powerful skill here for you use called, Revive. Now let's just guess what Revive is for. You've basically seen it already in, like, the first campaign, so. It's about time I basically got this for these guys, I think. Bring my guys back to their feet. So, finally get this out of the way. What else will I get them, I think? I may want to get a good patient, because that's usually very nice for doctors to have, just because they are usually targeted quite a bit, but... This isn't a bad one to get either. Hardened. So there we go, we just got hardened for our doctor here. Now, no, by the way, with, like, you know, these guys, it may be a good idea to try and, like, you know, get more, like, herbalism, because it's going to be, like, a lot harder, basically, on, like, this map, basically, to, like, you know, get medicine and stuff, so we'll get that right now, I think. So that's out of the way, finally. You took a hit, so let's just get you some more equipment. You took a hit, so let's get you some more equipment. I don't like that fatal being on her, but oh well, I gotta deal with it. That's not a great time to be attacked like this, but oh well, it happens. You get attacked. Give that to him. I think at this point we're just going out to the jungle, like out of the jungle over here. Like this is like the actual jungle part instead of like, you know, the marshy parts of like, you know, Mexico. Oh, what's that over there? I think that's a camp for like, you know, the jungles. And yet more battles over here, but you know, whatever. And yeah, basically it's like to chart the roads. Now, no, by the way, that guy's gonna be interesting to, like, you know, deal with later on, but for now, I'm gonna have to, you know, basically deal with my, like, injured companions first, so we'll do that first. Okay, so you got fatal, you can be treated right away, so take that. Rain is still severe, so I'll be able to treat with. I'm not basically what I have to do here is just try and, like, you know, get these guys to, like, you know, not die, so. I basically gotta, like, treat, like, you know, Hernandez first, and then, like, you know, try and get her, like, you know, up on her feet, and I'm up to start, like, going after, like, you know, the more injured guys after that will be the plan. So, that's basically how, like, you deal with, like, you know, really injured guys, unfortunately, in this game. You're gonna get double rations, of course, so... Get double rations. Why not? Make a spike trap. Actually, you know what? Don't make spike traps. I don't want her blowing up in her face again, so... Just go do herbalism. That's useful, I guess. She can at least do some herbalism. Both my doctors are doing stuff. You can't be treated right now, so that's unfortunate, but well. Let's see how this goes. Fast recovery. Much to your surprise, Daniel Hernandez seems to have gotten much better since yesterday. It looks like the scout will recover sooner than expected, which will of course save you some medicine. End event. Now, note by the way, because I didn't treat Adrenia, her condition actually deteriorated a lot because, like, you know, basically, you know, I didn't treat her. This is what happens when you don't, like, treat your people. They basically get, like, worse, so she's now in critical. But at the same time, I've only got three people who need to be treated at this point, so we're doing a lot better than, like, you know, we were last night, so that's great.